Well, folks, today we're going to look at the Bat Gremlin from NECA. NECA's been missing these Gremlin guys for a while now, and they do a pretty good job, I think. So, lots of details, and some good articulation, and so the little dots on the rings means that it's bendy. So we got bendy rings, even though I tried to bend those rings in the other direction, but it did not bend so much. So I don't know. Got the detail on the face. Now it opens and closes. It's got all those excellent details. I think they especially do a really good job on the paints of all this texture here. It's really cool. Look at the owls. It's beautiful. So, one thing you might find tricky is the base. It took me a little while to figure out how to get him on there, because it's not very elaborate. So here's what I did. So he's got two slats for his wings over here. And then I took this off first, I put it around his wrist, and then I attached it to the thingy, and then I just stand on it. Because, he don't stand very well without it, so, yeah. This is one of those instances where the back of the figure is actually cooler than the front of the figure. Look at the top of his head, man. He's even got little joints on his ears, so you can pull him back if you want to. Makes him extra expressive. Look at the pump. He's really cool. Originally thought he was going to come with the top of the steeple of the church. But they probably cost a lot of money. So, there's a little insert instead. Okay. Inside of the box. So you just stick him in front of it and pretend. Because that's to lose your imaginations. I think they did a really good job here. It's freaking awesome. And if they have a squad of all the other guys with the Spottle Gremlin and Stripe with the battle routes, then you should have a really, really crazy setup by now. Let's take a look at the articulation. So, we've got the thing's jaw. Whoops, all pulled over. See, without the stand, he don't hold the stand at all. That hurts him. Come here! I'm moving him closer. Don't hurt. Okay.
So we got Prince Jura up there. Prince Lewis. And the shoulders are not ball joints, so they don't go up so high. The elbows, hinges, and the wrists are ball joints, so the swivel around, and then the trunk. They got hips. I think they're supposed to be ball joints, but the sculpt doesn't let it move so much. We got the knees. So there's a lot of pegs and hinges going on here. So you know, the sculpt is gonna get in the way a little bit, but I mean, how articulated do you need a gremlin to be? So same with the ankles, with the pegs and the hinges. So that means it goes up and down and it goes side to side too. And then, as I said before, the bundle. So those are dots that usually means bundles. So if you ever find that on a tour, it means bundles. Look at those little fingers. So yeah, I'll try to bundle them in the other direction, and it did not work so much. So, maybe the bundle in there is not the bundle, I think. So, but still a really, really cool figure, I think. Even though he don't stand for nothing. He don't wanna stand. So, I got to hold him. So, the Bat Gremlin is in stores now. You should go to a local comic shop and ask them if they got it or if they can do it, because those guys need more business than the big guys. So, yeah. Go get the Bat Gremlin today, because he's really, really cool. Really, really creepy. Look at the creepy face! He's creepy.
Where'd you go?